us to come into His presence and to worship Him and praise His name. This Wednesday, we'll have our elder who will be taking us to the midweek service, and we trust that the Lord is going to be with us. We shall be sharing the Lord, our refuge. Our theme, the Lord, our refuge. Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, we give you the praise, we give you the honor for another opportunity, dear Lord, you have given us to hear your word and interact with you, O Lord. We pray, Jehovah Lord, that you may operate in us, dear Lord Jehovah. You may open our inner eyes, our inner ears, King of all the glory, O Lord. That Jehovah Lord, Father, we may hear from you, O Lord. We commit Elder Brother unto you, dear Lord Jehovah, as he shares and speaks of your honor cause, O Lord. And as he shares you that is our refuge, King of all the glory, Abba Father. May you speak and reveal unto us. In the mighty name of Jesus, do we pray and we give thanks.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. This afternoon, I'm excited to be in the presence of the Lord, even to share the word of God that has inspired my spirit this past 1 week. And I want to speak concerning God as a refuge. And I want us to share the scripture in the book of 2 Samuel, chapter 22, verse 1 through to 4. And as we go on through the service, we shall mention other scriptures. I'm reading from the NIV version. David sang to the Lord the words of this song when the Lord delivered him from the hand of all his enemies and from the hand of Saul. He said, "The Lord is my rock, my fortress, and my deliverer. My God is my rock, in whom I take refuge, my shield and the horn of my salvation. He is my stronghold, my refuge, and my savior. From violent men you save me. I call to the Lord, who is worthy of praise, and I am saved from my enemies." When I have been going through the book of Samuel, the two books, one thing I have gotten to know is that very few things went smoothly for David. Every step of his life attracted some kind of controversy from enemies outside Israel and from within. And thus he was faced with the choice of doing things in man's way, that is the way of the flesh, or God's way. The verse 1 talks about enemies and mentions Saul, who was a king when he was anointed and when the Lord was building up to take over the leadership of Israel and Judah later in his life. Number 2, in this scripture, verse 2, he talks about terms that he is speaking concerning God. And these terms are static, they are physical. They are talking about a location, a foundation. So, I want to define the word refuge and say it is a place where you can run for life in times of trouble or where you can get help. So, a refuge is a place of safety. Number 3, when David proclaims the Lord as so, it shows that he is not distant. God is not distant. He is not far from us, but is near. David had a personal and intimate relationship with God every day of his life. And that is the desire that the Lord has for us as a church and as his saints, a time like now, especially when we are experiencing the uncertainties in the world, in the nation, even in our lives. This is a demand for us. Number 4. Christ is a savior who is common to all believers and a God that is universal in his life for each of his own. But he does not divide his love. He does not segment his peace or subdivide his grace between us. He pours out all his love
on each of us. He showers upon us this boundless grace. So if it is you as an individual that the Lord has to deal with, he will pour his hold on you. And that is a promise. And I'm excited by our God because of that. From this scripture, we notice two things or two connections for safety. And one of them, in this NIV, verse 3, he says, my God is my rock, in whom I take refuge. The King James Version says, God is my rock, in him I will trust. When that the word trust brings up the essence of faith. So, one condition for safety, for God to be a refuge, is to have faith in God. And Psalms 91 and verse 2, and verse 1 and 2, the word of the Lord says this. Psalms 91, verse 1 and 2. He who dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in whom I trust. So, for you to experience God as a refuge, you must be able to dwell in the sacred place of the Most High. That is, you must have faith in God and accept him as Lord and Master in your life. Jesus spoke to a man when he came down from the Mount of Transfiguration in the book of Mark chapter 9. And also it's mentioned in Matthew chapter 17. And this man had brought his son to be delivered by the 9 disciples of Jesus who were not with Jesus on the Mount of Transfiguration. And this man was accusing the 9 disciples that they were unable to deliver his son. And Jesus, in Mark 9 verse 23, tells him that everything is possible for him who believes. So, for us to experience the promise of refuge, we must have confidence in our God. Amen? Number 2. This verse 4 we have read. We have read in the scripture. The one says that I call to the Lord. That is prayer. Prayer. The next condition is prayer. Psalms 50 and verse 15 says, I'll call the Lord in the day of trouble. And the Lord has promised to deliver me, to deliver you. And I and you will glorify him. So the sense of pain, the sense of trouble, the sense of knowing that they are accepted in God and that deliverance power is exercised on behalf of those who seek him leads the Christian to prayer. And Paul states in the book of Ephesians chapter 6 and verse 18 that you should pray always in the Spirit with all kinds of prayer and request. So, for us to experience a movement of refuge, we need to be men and women of prayer. Number 6, the divine promises when you make God a refuge. And from the scripture in Psalms 91, from verse 9 through to 12, it talks about 3 great promises. One promise is that no evil will befall us when we have made God our refuge. Number 1, no plague will come near you, even this COVID-19 and all other plagues that are destined to befall mankind, they will not come upon you when you have made him a refuge. And number 3, the one says in Psalms 91 verse 11 through to 12 that he will command his angels to take charge over your life. I am happy that his angels continues to carry me every moment of my life. Nobody. Psalms 9 and verse 10. The word of the Lord says, those who know your name will trust in you, for you, Lord, have never forsaken those who seek you. It means this: when you have known Lord and trusted in him as our refuge, he has promised never to forsake us. What a promise. That the Lord, as he promised Israel in Deuteronomy, that he will not forsake them. He will not fail them. So he is promising us as we make him our refuge. Psalms 57 and verse 1. The word of the Lord says, when we have made him our refuge and we have trusted on him, he will be merciful to us. We need mercy. A time like now, in the nation, even in the church, even in our families, considering the experiences we are going through. And number F, Psalms 46 and verse 1. The word of the Lord says, when we are, God is our refuge, he is our strength and an ever-present help. So when we have made this God our refuge, he has promised us strength. He has promised to be ever present in all areas of our lives. And therefore, we should boldly declare and walk with our Lord as our refuge. Number 7, the result of making God our refuge. And in the scripture that we have read, 2 Samuel chapter 22, verse 50 and 51, talks about the results of making our God our refuge. He says in verse 50, therefore, I will praise you, O Lord, among the nations. I will sing praises to your name. He gives his king great victories. He shows unfailing kindness to his anointed, to David and his descendants forever. So, they are results of making God a refuge. So, man is able to fulfill his mandate and riches worship, bringing thanksgiving and bringing praise unto the Lord. The whole essence of man. Praise God. May the Lord enable you and me to stand firm, to fulfill the mandate bestowed upon us as he has anointed us in his making us realize that he is the refuge in our lives. May God bless you. Let us pray. Eternal and everlasting Father, your word is a strong tower. You have reminded us that you are our deliverer, our rock, our shield, our refuge, and the horn of our salvation. And you have promised to be a strength to us always. Therefore, this afternoon, we release our rights to you, O God, even our nation, and even the church, O God of heaven, that we shall start boldly to proclaim you as our refuge and Jehovah God as our fortress, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I pray for the congregation, O God of heaven, who have, O God, had patience to listen to your word, O God, this afternoon. And I speak your blessings concerning their lives and your deliverance to the glory of your holy name. We thank you and we bless you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.